Hi, let's talk about Alma's integration with self-check machines. Alma supports the integration of SIP2 self-check machines to allow patrons to check out and check in library items. In order to set up the self-check integration in Alma, you'll go through the following steps. First, you'll need to create a self-check integration profile. This profile will define the activities allowed by the machine and can also support a group of machines if they all provide the same services for one circulation desk. Second, you'll assign the profile to a circulation desk. Third, install and configure S-Tunnel. And fourth, configure the self-check machine to communicate via the S-Tunnel server. Let me show you how to set this up in Alma. First, we will create a self-check integration profile. You'll need to have the role of General Administrator. Go to the Alma Configuration menu, select General, then click on Integration Profiles. Click on Add Integration Profile and give the profile a code and a name. For this example, we are setting up a profile for the self-check machines in the Law Library. So I'll name it Law Library Self-Check and give it the code LAWLIBSC. Select self-check from the integration type menu and select the brand of self-check machine you are configuring, then click Next. Under SC identifiers, you can provide any value you like. I'm going to enter the model number of the self-check machine I'll be connecting to this profile. For the rest of the values on this form, it's going to be very important to make sure what you enter in Alma matches the configuration settings for your machine. A good example of this is the first option, error correction. If you select yes, Alma will be able to send and receive sequence numbers and checksums to help detect errors in data. Whether you decide to use this feature or not, it's imperative that the setting you select in Alma matches the setting on the self-check machine. Select yes for the alert option if you want Alma to be able to exchange alert messages with the machine. Item transfer messages are not currently supported, so you can leave this option set to no. Select the language that Alma and the self-check machine will use to communicate. Then enter the number of retries a patron is allowed in the case of failed scanning and the timeout period. The recommended number of retries is between 2 to 5, and the recommended timeout period is between 50 to 70 seconds. It's important that whatever you select here matches your self-check machine configuration. Next, fill in the actions supported by the self-check machine. Note that if you're using a 3M machine, you must select the check-in option. It's needed for the initial connection every time the machine is turned on. You can turn the option to check-in materials off when you configure your machine, but in Alma, you will need to leave the check-in option selected. You can learn more about each of these options in the online help. You don't need to worry about selecting an extension type unless your machine accepts payment. Even then, not all machines support the extension type options, so please refer to the online help to learn more about them and determine if they apply to your self-check machine. Select your item identifier, then select Yes under Authentication Required if you want patrons to provide a password in order to use the machine. Selecting Yes for the Close Process option means any open work orders relevant to an item that's being checked out will be marked as done. For example, if an item mistakenly gets to the shelf before being marked as received, the work order will be closed when a patron checks that item out through the self-check machine. Your last choice is to prevent patrons from checking out items that have a hold request placed on them. Once you've completed your selections, click Save to save your integration profile. Now you'll see it in the list. You need to go into the profile, click on Actions, and click on Download Certificate. This downloads a file with the encryption key needed to set up the S-Tunnel integration later on. Now that we've created our self-check integration profile, let's associate it with a circulation desk. If your Alma project is still in implementation, you may need to contact your Ex Libris project manager to perform this for you. From the configuration menu, select the library you want to assign the machine to. Then, under Fulfillment, select Circulation Desks. You can either associate the machine with a desk that already exists, or create a desk that is specifically for the self-check machine profile. We are going to associate our self-check machine with the main circulation desk in our law library. I'll click on the desk name, then scroll down to the self-check information section. I'll click on the box to indicate this desk has self-check, then select the profile I created for the law library machine. You can use Alma to generate a password or supply one of your own, or leave it empty. Note that if you do use a password, the machine has to have it configured as well. The last step is to configure the S-Tunnel connection between Alma and the self-check machine. Since Alma is run remotely, secure communication is provided by S-Tunnel, a free proxy server. You can find detailed instructions in the Ex Libris Developer Network. You can learn more about self-check integration in general in the Alma Online Help by searching for self-check machines. You can also find lots of information on the Ex Libris Developer Network under self-check, including common troubleshooting steps, as well as steps to perform end-to-end testing of your connection to Alma.